Good day, everybody. My name is Tony. Barbados born. This time of the year, this is a big thing for us at Easter time, flying kites. So I'm going to attempt to show you guys how to make a kite. I pre-made my own sticks, and they're about 18 inches in length. And they're like, what, a quarter inch in thickness, and 3/8 in width. First thing to begin is you center a pin, which is going to hold them all together in the center. Just kidding around. A little bit difficult sometimes. And I'll fold the pin over. Hold it in place. So this is already preset. The next thing I do is I cut some little slots in the top, because that's how I'm going to spring the top out. But you have to position this in a way, because this is the way that you fly the kite. So you have to be very, very careful, okay? Now the next thing you're going to try to do is you're going to try to evenly space these things out. I already pre-measured these here, so I soldered, just not take up so much time. Very important to evenly space these things out, so that when you start to put the paper on, you can pre-cut some of it. So my sticks are 18 inches in length by 3/8 in width by 1/4 inch in thickness. So my spacing between each stick is actually 6 and 6.5 inches. When I was much younger growing up, we would make the kite sticks of red herring box. That's a fish, you know, something like codfish. Comes in a crate. too. Now that's the frame finished, made up, equally spaced out. Now we can get to this other little part here, is what we call the round head. So I cut a piece of board maybe about an inch longer than center point and shave it now. Shave it on one end and just gradually slide it underneath here. Taking a piece of bamboo and I cut two small holes in the top, and this is what we call the round head. And you want to position it more or less in the center. That's one frame finish. Yep. Okay, as I said before, this is one frame finish built. And this is the way how we hold a kite to fly it, to put it up. If there's two people trying to fly it, you know, one go down, put it up in the air, the other one with a string. This is the way how we hold it, okay? So now, you can use anything for backing. If you don't want to put pretty paper on it, you can use brown paper, you can use a used paper, whatever tickle your fancy. You want to put some pretty paper on it. So, you can use cornstarch, you can boil it into a paste, you can use flour, you can do the same thing, put it on. When you were poor back home, you didn't have any of those things, there's a special berry that blows on a tree, we call it clapper cherry. It's very sticky, it looks something like a bread, and we would use that. Home at Easter time, everybody, young and old, fly kites, make kites, buy kites, whatever the case may be, whatever you can afford. There's actually a big kite competition at Easter, win lots of money, could even win a car too. Biggest car, biggest kite, smallest kite. So you trim this paper a little bit wider. I am folding the end, I'm folding the end of the paper over so that string that I wrapped around the bones to hold it all in place. Also too, at Easter time, for Good Friday, we would only fly black and white kites. Yeah. You can use an over knife, a plain razor blade, just anything to cut with. Okay, so I'm folding over the end of the paper over to the twine that held the bones in place, or the frame in place.
So this is considered as a kite finish build. You can fly it like this, or if you want to make it look pretty, well, then that's the next stage. And what I'm about to make now is what they call the bull, the noisemaker. What I just make here, I just take the paper and fold it in half because it has to be glued on here. And this is the part when you're flying it, it makes all the noise. As I home now, you can't sleep kites out anymore because it make noise all night long. But they still do. And it has to be able to move freely so that the wind can move it around. So, okay, so as I mentioned before, this actually is considered as a finished kite, but if you want to put any pretty paper on it, feel free. Like home, we can sleep our kites out because the wind blows in one direction, not like up here. 1 minute you're flying one way, next minute you're flying another way. And it's easy for the kite to fall. So you can make any pattern that you want. What I did here is I already think about a pattern that I want to make. So I made just a small little template. Okay. Now I transfer a template to the paper, which I already done. That's how it's done. Okay.
So you would go around, do every other, whatever colors you want to do. What I'm about to make here is a little centerpiece, which we always put it in to hide any imperfections where you join all your papers. Okay, I'm about to show you how we string up these kites to fly them. You can pre-drill a hole, then you can take a needle and you can guide the string through it. Okay, so we loop the string through and we pull it up to the center. That we'll leave that there for now. So that's where you connect your string to fly it. Now this is the part for the tail. lots of knots, so the string will pull back out. About to the center again. Centerpiece. We need it to be in the center, approximately maybe 2 inches down from the top. This is just maybe an old sheet, you just take strips all of it. Tailpiece is approximately maybe about 20 feet. All you have to do now is tie your string onto it and you're ready to fly. This is Tony. Last name is Bathwaite from Barbados at the Art Centre. Travel with us. Okay, and this is the finished product. Thank you very much. Enjoy.